Welcome everyone, I'm Dr. Saurabh Jindal. Today we'll speak about the role of green tea in intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting, I've had a few videos on my YouTube channel before this about what is permitted in the fasting window of intermittent fasting, and I've focused in most of these videos on the importance of green tea inside that fasting window. It doesn't break your fast and it has brilliant effects in your body. So what are the effects of green tea and how does it help you? Tea, as you would know, is one of the most consumed drinks in the world. In fact, after water, it's the second most consumed drink. Green tea actually is a non-fermented tea and contains numerous catechins. This green tea has been considered now as a medicine and is one of the healthiest beverages to consume. It is loaded with antioxidants and nutrients that have powerful effects on your body. As a doctor, it's important for me to be able to separate just the whims and fancies from the actual facts. So in this video today, we'll quickly go through numerous studies which have happened in green tea so you have an evidence-based view on whether green tea is actually as good as it's made out to be. What is green tea? Green tea basically is composed of proteins, about 15 to 20% of the weight of that, carbohydrates. But what we are really focused on is polyphenols. Polyphenols is one of the best things green tea has, and most of the benefits of green tea come from this polyphenol compound. It's also got caffeine and theophylline. It's got minerals and trace elements like zinc and copper and calcium and magnesium. But we need to focus mainly on the polyphenols. The polyphenol which we really need to look at here is something which is called as epigallocatechin gallate. EGCG is the short form we will use in this video, and this EGCG is one of the most potent, powerful antioxidants we have. In fact, the power of this is in fact almost as equal to vitamin E, even more than vitamin C. So it's a very powerful antioxidant that we can consume. In fact, there are many studies which have happened on the beneficial effects of green tea. This is a review that I went through, published in the Journal of American College of Nutrition. They basically found out that EGCG and catechins were in the following order. Green tea, the old leaves of green tea, were the most potent when it comes to EGCG, more than green tea of young leaves, more than oolong tea, more than black tea. So if you see here, the green tea is a very potent beverage to actually have. They actually compared the EGCG component of green tea versus black tea. And what did they found? They found that green tea happens to have a lot of EGCG, and that's a huge amount of benefit you'd get from there, whereas black tea would not have as much. Black tea would have much lower concentration. So you want to choose between black tea and green tea in the fasting window, good to choose the green tea. They also went on to say that the green tea has got anti-mutagenic, which means anti-cancer agents, anti-diabetic agents, antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, and hypocholesterolemic, means it lowers your cholesterol, lowers your lipid. Go down further. They also mentioned that it's protective against dental caries and in fact tooth loss. So something as simple as having some cups of green tea can protect oral health. They also now say very prominently that now it's a cancer preventive agent. So what better to do than just in the fasting time to boost up your anti-cancer activity just by green tea. Now LDL, all of you would know that LDL is a bad cholesterol. It's been infamous because it creates a lot of heart disease and a lot of narrowing of your blood vessels going to your heart. That LDL oxidation reduces by green tea, so that's beneficial for the heart as well. It also promotes fat oxidation, which means that it burns fat. So intermittent fasting by itself burns fat, and just by putting in the beverage of green tea, you are boosting that fat metabolism, so you're going to lose weight that much more. Green tea increases insulin activity, and this is a very important EGCG element. It increases the insulin sensitivity, but if you add a bit of milk into that cup, that it reduces then that activity and the protective activity that you'd get, and that's why it's good to have black tea without milk, and you can have green tea as well. Green tea has got a good activity against viruses. In this in this modern era of so many pandemics that's happened, SARS, MERS, now there's a COVID virus, which is coronavirus, which is going around, which is really decimating population. It's such a big problem. Is it not a good thing? People ask us, oh, tell us something which boosts our immune system. Green tea has had a good documented activity against influenza viruses, especially in its earlier stages. So there's no harm in trying that out for other viruses as well. It's also got an activity against another virus called as herpes simplex virus. In fact, there's been a lot of studies of tea catechins on the influenza infection and common cold. And it's such a common problem. Even common cold disrupts so many school days for so many children and even elderly population and adults. In fact, studies do exhibit that EGCG exhibits broad spectrum antiviral activities against various families. The study also shows that it's got potential anti-influenza agent protection in various experimental studies. They also brought out so many numerous studies. Look at the first one. 2050 primary school children were asked to consume green tea, and that prevented influenza infection. Multiple studies, look at the third one, significantly lower incidence of influenza infection in the catechin group. This was done in 197 eligible healthcare workers. It was a randomized controlled trial as well. The study also shows that just simple gargling with green tea in comparison to tap water lowered the fever onset. Look at the first study, about 20,000 children in nursery school age group of 2 to 6 years were asked to gargle with green tea and they had lower fever. Second study, one more, 124 nursing home residents, significant lower incidence of influenza infection. Third one, about 400 healthy adults were randomized. Influenza infection was 1% compared to the other control group where it was 2%. So definitely green tea, even gargling, is protective. Now, what blew my mind about green tea was there is actually a published CDC website page that you can go through as well. The Center for Disease Control in America, which publishes guidelines for treatment of diseases. As dermatologists, we see a lot of sexually transmitted diseases. A green tea ointment, which is called cyanocatechin, is now in the official guidelines for treatment for a viral infection called as warts. It in fact almost clears 100% of warts in about 50% of the people. It's a very powerful agent. So you can understand the antiviral role of green tea just from that. They also compared green tea consumption and its effects on blood pressure. And to everyone's surprise, about 1400 subjects were analyzed, given green tea, and they found significant reduction in systolic blood pressure and even diastolic blood pressures. And as the last line would say, the meta-analysis now, which is a very big study, suggested that green tea consumption had a favorable effect on decreasing the blood pressure. Just one cup of green tea a day was associated with about 10% decrease in developing a coronary artery disease. So you can see the amount of benefit you would get just from there. In conclusion, this study conclusively proved that it is definitely a helpful thing for lowering blood pressure, and in concordance with that, reduces so many other diseases linked to blood pressure. Weight loss, also a meta-analysis we checked out. This meta-analysis tells that there is an enhancement of energy expenditure and fat oxidation, thereby reducing the weight just with green tea consumption. And this then has a good positive role in either maintaining if you have a good low weight, or has a positive effect on weight loss. There's also talk about breast cancer prevention with green tea. And studies do show a marginally significant reduction of about 27% in recurrence of breast cancers in heavy green tea drinkers. That's about more than three cups a day. And otherwise, incidence of breast cancer also reduced by about 19% among women with high green tea consumption. So that is why we would now say it's even chemoprotective, prevents against cancers. There are studies now on green tea and bone metabolism. And you can't even believe that green tea can affect bone health. And it shows there's decreased risk of fracture, and increasing the bone mineral density makes your bones stronger. And that's the beneficial effect here as well. So it all put together, There's no reason for you not to consume as much green tea as you can. You can see from this short analysis of so many different studies, it definitely doesn't harm you. In fact, it's got magical beneficial effects. You can put that into the intermittent fasting regimen and then it boosts up. It's like the cherry on the cake. Do that and you will really see the improvement in your overall health. This is Dr. Saurabh Jindal signing off. This is my short attempt at changing the world 1 kilo at a time. God bless and thank you for your attention.